Hey, this week it's my second Jazzmaster build. Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. Before we get started today, I just want to remind you guys to subscribe down below and also hit that notification bell so you get all of my latest content as soon as it arrives. So this week we're revisiting something that I've done before on the channel, and that is a build of a Jazzmaster. This is going to be a little bit different than the build I've done before, some different components, a different layout and everything, but it was well received last time and it just so happens I'm in a position where I'm going to be able to do it again. So if you're familiar with the channel, you'll know, like I said before, that this is my second Jazzmaster build. My first Jazzmaster was built around a Squire Vintage Modified Jazzmaster, which I dubbed the Ultimate Vintage Modified Jazzmaster. We used a Squire neck and a Squire body, but then pretty much preloaded it with Fender components and a Bigsby vibrato. So I really liked that guitar, but I ended up selling it about a couple weeks ago. I had it for about 2 or 3 months, which I did enjoy using it, but I wanted something different. I wanted to go through the build process again, and I just thought this thing, what I've got today, is exactly what I was looking for. The centerpiece for this build is going to be this Jazzmaster body I purchased from Warmoth. This body is a little bit different than the body I used for my Ultimate Vintage Modified Jazzmaster. This one is swamp ash as opposed to a basswood, which the Squire body was. This one is also routed for a strat-like tremolo as opposed to the standard Jazzmaster tremolo. And of course, the color is a little bit different. My Vintage Modified Jazzmaster was in Sonic Blue, and this is Warmoth's Daphne Blue. So you can probably see, if you were to compare the two videos, that this is a little bit more saturated in color. Maybe darker is a better word to describe it. I really dig the Daphne Blue color, more so than the Sonic Blue color. And I would also say that Warmoth's Daphne Blue is probably a little bit more saturated than even what you would get from Fender. But I'm digging it. I think it's going to make for a great looking instrument overall. So a couple things about this body. I've already touched on the routing for the bridge and tremolo. This is for a 2-point Stratocaster tremolo system. And I think that will just make the build that much easier. My Vintage Modified, although I put a Bigsby on it, I did run into some extra steps, we'll say, when I had to route out the body to lower the bridge section for a tunematic style bridge. I don't have to do this with this one because my tremolo and bridge system will all be one piece, and I just really like the simplicity of it. Lastly, you'll see the 2-point tremolo system studs are already embedded in this body. When you order from Warmoth, you can just order your studs and they'll put them in there for you. It saves a step on my end, and yeah, they're done well. I have no problems with them, and if I did, I could always reach out to Warmoth. So that's why I spent the extra couple bucks and got them to do that step for me. So what are we going to populate this body with? What kind of hardware are we using? Well, it's going to be pretty much centered around the Fender Player Series Mexican hardware. I've got a Fender Player Series 2-point tremolo system that was off of a Fender Player Series Stratocaster. I really enjoy that Fender upgraded all of their Mexican line with these 2-point tremolo systems. They've also added little things like imprinting the Fender name onto the saddles. Just makes everything feel more like a Fender. And if you're buying a Mexican Strat, you know, I think this is a really cool upgrade. I wish for my Mexican Telecaster to have had something like this when I purchased it as well. So electronics wise, we're going to keep it pretty close to what I used in the Ultimate Vintage Modified Jazzmaster build that I've previously done. I really dug those 65 or pure 65 Jazzmaster pickups from Fender. I've got another set of them here with all of the electronics associated with them. You know, we've got the 500K CTS pots, so 500K as opposed to 1 meg that you might see in an actual vintage Jazzmaster. Just cuts off a little bit of the high end. This will still have tons of treble in it, but just lowering those pots just makes for a little bit more even sound. Also, you can see I've got the cream colored knobs and pickup covers. I think that's gonna add to a great color combo with the Daphne Blue body and the Pickguard I'm about to show. The Pickguard was ordered from Warmoth as well. I ordered it when I ordered the body. You can do your own custom cut of a Pickguard. This one is obviously cut for a Jazzmaster with the Stratocaster style tremolo system. You can also choose what you want in the way of holes where you want your toggle switch and stuff like that. So I've got this done for none of the rhythm lead circuit. I don't need that in my Jazzmaster. I've moved the toggle switch from the upper left-hand corner to the bottom left-hand corner, which I think will keep it out of the way, and it's more of a common position for Jazzmaster. And finally, I've got my three holes here for my input, my tone, and my volume. So I believe that this in white with the cream colored pickup covers is gonna give it that vintage look. It's gonna go really well with my Daphne blue body. So I think this is gonna be really cool. Also, you should note on the back of these when you order them from Warmoth, they do add some shielding, but I'll probably add my own copper shielding over top of most of this as well. We've talked about the body, we've talked about electronics, hardware, and also the pickguard. The last thing to go over is the neck. So the neck is going to be from that Fender Player series as well. Really liking what they're doing with that whole series. I probably should just end up buying one of those guitars anyway. But yeah, we've got a Fender Jazzmaster Player Series neck here. So the neck is Pau Ferro fretboard with medium jumbo frets. It's a maple neck. So you can see the nice skunk stripe on the back as well. It's a satin urethane gloss on the back, and it is a, or satin urethane on the back, and it's gloss urethane here on the headstock. This is from 2018. So, you know, fairly new neck. And also one thing you'll get over the other Mexicans is you get that 22nd fret, which is kind of cool. Lastly, on the neck, I haven't touched the nut. I probably won't, at least for some time, unless I think it's bothering me. It looks pretty good right now, so I'm gonna leave the nut as opposed to putting in a Tusk XL, which I normally do. I've already put in a rolling string tree here, and that's just something I'll do on all my guitars. When this neck came in, that was the first thing I did. But the other cool thing that is really nice that came with this neck are these tuners. These are Fender locking tuners. I actually have these on my Fender guitars. And when I saw this neck with those tuners, I thought, you know, this is a great deal. And, you know, it's gonna be a really nice neck that goes well with this Jazzmaster build. So that's all for the components of this Jazzmaster build. I think it's gonna be a straightforward assembly. It's not gonna take a lot of time. I didn't have to do anything extra. You know, the steps that Warmoth took for me really is gonna save a little bit of time. I think the biggest thing I'm gonna have to do is shield the body with my copper tape, which I've got here. I'll get video of that. I'll get video of the whole assembly, but let's just jump right into it and see what this Jazzmaster is going to look like, sound like, and what the build's gonna be like. We'll be right back. A couple days have passed, but I'm back from the shop and I'm able to show you my finished, what I'm calling my Warmoth Performer Jazzmaster. So obviously there's lots of Fender components on here, but I really think the main piece of this is this Warmoth body. It looks just awesome. The color is excellent. It goes great with this Pau Ferro fretboard, the white pickguard, and the aged plastic. Not sure if I'll keep the aged plastic. I might go for, you know, the straight white on white, but right now I do like that aged plastic on there. I'm calling it the Performer Jazzmaster because it really looks very similar to the Performer Jazzmasters that Fender's just released in their American line with the Strat Tremolo. So very happy with that. Really not too much stuff you guys missed in the build. Obviously the setup of the guitar, setting the intonation, you know, setting the action, stuff like that, that's all personal to me, so I didn't really feel like it needed to go in necessarily the build video. One thing that I did come across that might be useful for you guys is with the Strat Tremolo, the tremolo arm here, I'll pick it up again. When I first put this together, when I screwed my tremolo arm in, because these witch hat knobs for the Jazzmaster sit a little bit higher than Stratocaster knobs, I did have to bend that tremolo arm just up a bit. It's nothing too crazy. I might actually bend it a little bit more too so I can get past my right angle plug here. But it's a really simple process. I don't have any video of it, but I can show you quickly what I did. Basically, just take a piece of scrap wood. You're gonna drill usually about a 3/16 hole into it. Slam this into the vise. You have a tremolo arm like this. And all you do is you're gonna wedge that into your hole here, like that. So now you're not affecting your threads on your tremolo arm. And then once this is in a vise, you can bend this bar back. And you just apply some easy constant pressure and you've got a set up tremolo arm as much as you want it. So yeah, other than that, very happy with the build. Like I said, you know, with my last Jazzmaster, I know this one's gonna stick around. Just playing it the first little bit, it's really got some nice gritty Jazzmaster pickups. It's just time to stop talking about it and play you guys some tunes. Obviously, I'm not the best guitarist in the world, but hopefully you guys will enjoy this and see what you can build at home. So this is my Warmoth Performer Jazzmaster. I hope you guys like it. Make sure to like, subscribe, and we'll see you next week. Thanks.